Oh, look! This cloud looks like a crab. And next to it, there is a pizza.
Oh, and this one. This cloud is a very special cloud because this cloud is my IoT Arduino cloud. And today I'm going to show you how you can create your own thing. Let's go! When people hear cloud computing, they often think it's some advanced mysterious technology. But in reality, you've been probably using the cloud for years. Maybe even since you were born. Streaming music? Cloud. Watching Netflix? Cloud. Saving files on Google Drive? Yep, it's a cloud. So what exactly is this cloud services? In simple terms, it's like a giant computer that lives somewhere else. You send data to it, it processes it things for you, and then sends back the results. So instead of running all those software complicated things on your laptop or on your phone, you're using the internet to access it from remote servers. And here's the best part. Making your own Internet of Things project on the cloud is not that hard. A few years ago, setting an IoT system was complicated. It required tons of coding, complex networking, and relying on third-party platforms. But today, I can install an app, create a push button, connect this board to the internet, and boom! This LED matrix becomes a part of an IoT project. Arduino Cloud was created to remove these barriers, making IoT more accessible, seamless, and beginners-friendly. It allows you to focus on what really matters, which is your project, without getting stuck on the complicated setups. Of course, if you want to dive into how the internet works, go for it, but if you don't, you can skip it. In my opinion, one of the biggest motivations behind Arduino Cloud was the simplicity. Many IoT platforms require users to piece together different services for data collection, remote control, and automation. But with Arduino Cloud, everything is in one place. You can manage, monitor, automate, and control your devices in one place. But what really stands out, at least again for me, is that the Arduino Cloud doesn't just support official Arduino boards. It welcomes third-party devices as well. It's like owning a private jet but letting others to fly with you for free because you just have the extra seat. This openness allows more people to experiment with IoT without being locked into a single ecosystem. There are two more features I haven't personally tested, but I know they make things even easier. The OTA updates, which is over-the-air updates, and automation with no-code tools. OTA updates mean that you don't have to keep your Arduino plugged into your PC to update the code. It just needs the power and connection to the internet. And no-code automation allows you to create if this then that scenarios, and from what I understand, it's like coding for babies, but in a good way. It simplifies programming so anyone can build automation without writing a single line of code. So now let me show you how you can get started with the Arduino Cloud through a quick demo. To keep it simple, we are going to use the Arduino Uno R4, and what we are going to do is just to install an app, click on the button, which is a thing on my phone, and display a message on the LED matrix. By the way, if you're missing anything, check TME.eu. We have there all the Arduinos that you want. But not only. At TME, you will find thousands of high-quality components from trusted brands, and 96% of the orders are fulfilled at the same day, so you can get started on your projects without delay. Let's get to it. So, first of all, we go to Arduino website, which is arduino.cc, and click on the cloud button on the top right corner. If you don't have an account, click create an account button and fill the form. I'll be signing in with my Google account for my own simplicity. On the left side, you have the navigation bar that can take you to devices, sketches, things, and so on, but I found that it is easier to start with creating a thing. So Press add and fill the data about your variables, and since it is a simple push button, I will call it Benjamin. Benjamin, and set it as Boolean. I usually name my variable with capital letters, so this one I will change here. Now we need to select the device. And here we can see what I was talking about previously. Not only Arduino boards are allowed, but also third-party devices and any other device that runs Python, MicroPython, JavaScript and Node.js, but you will have to configure it manually. So for this tutorial I'm using Arduino Uno RF Wi-Fi board. Okay, so after connecting your device to the machine, in order for it to communicate properly with the cloud, you need to download and install the Cloud Engine. So when your agent is ready, you can now close this tab. The agent is going to be running in the background, as you can see here, and it has already detected the board. So, okay, let's configure it. Wow, the process can take up to 5 minutes. For your convenience, we're gonna speed it up. Let's give it our own name, R2D2, because Arduino and R2D2 sound similar. Congratulations, R2D2 has been successfully set up. Next important step is to configure the network. I have already set this up, but all you have to do is to fill the name and the password of your Wi-Fi to which your board is going to be connected. Now we go to the sketch. As you can see, Arduino Cloud has already implemented some functions that allows us to connect to the cloud, and similarly to the Arduino IDE, we have here the setup and the loop. We also have a README document, Think properties header file, where we have the definition of our things, like our Benjamin here. You shouldn't change it, but I would like it to set it to false. Alright, okay, that's good. In the sketch secrets, you'll find your Wi-Fi name and password. Those comments we can clean up from the sketch a little bit. And our goal is to click on Benjamin, and then a text on the LED matrix should appear. To do so, we can go to a short tutorial made by Arduino about the LED matrix for the Uno Wi-Fi module. Go all the way up for the scrolling text example. Copy it and paste it, the right parts into our sketch, into the correct places. The text Uno with capital letters is what is going to be displayed constantly on the matrix, but it is a little bit too large, so we are going to use small letters for Uno only. Maybe later we will play with the font here. Some small adjustments to the code, although those comments are very helpful for those who need them. So if you are sharing your code with someone else, leave them. The text that we would like to display when the button is pressed is TME.eu. This whole code is going to be a function on Benjamin chain, so when we call it, the text will appear on the matrix. With the function ready, let's call it into the loop and upload it to our R2D2. Okay, great. The sketch is verified and uploaded. Now we can go to the dashboard. One thing that I forgot is to rename the sketch. I will call it Pilot since it is our first try. But you can leave it untitled, but you shouldn't. Again, if you are working with other people, it is better, or you have more sketches, better name it properly. Now we go and create our dashboard from which we are going to control Benjamin. Go to Edit and add a push button. I will rename it to Benjamin and link it to our Benjamin in the sketch. Since you can also control it via app on your phone, you can check how it will look like on the phone. Now let's just put it in the center and it's done. Okay. With that said, let's get back to the sketch and define that only when Benjamin is pressed, we are going to display the text. Okay, let's see if everything works well. And if yes, let's upload it. On your phone, you need to download the IoT remote, log in and enter the dashboard. From some reason, it is not working as I wanted it. Let's try to fix it in the code. Let's make the function draw Uno and call it if we didn't press anything. Okay, so still, from some reason, the text is displayed twice. If anyone knows what is the problem or how we can fix it, maybe you can make a comment in the comments section. And yeah, or maybe we will try to fix it next time.
You know what's the problem with all this programming? That sometimes it's so fun that we forget to go outside and enjoy the sun. So just don't forget it. Go out and enjoy the sun and the clouds and the plants.